So I have never taken an animation class ever. I actually went to school for graphic design and then dabbled in illustration, which I never took a class of either. And I ended up teaching at OCAD illustration. So anyway, I grew up in Mexico and I went to university in Mexico. And at some point I was watching TV and this show Splat comes on. And they profile a studio in Toronto called Cup of Coffee Animation. And at some point I said, well, you know what? That's what I want to do. I want to work in a studio like that. Fast forward to a few years later, I moved to Toronto, and I'll go by in a bit. I got a quick job at the advertising agency. And then finally, someone at Cup of Coffee calls me. It was actually Adam Shaheen. And so I come in and I start working on it. Now, I went to school for graphic design, and back then computers were coming in, and I just dove into it because, you know, like just doing stuff manually was really hard for me. Computers cleaned up my work really nicely, so I was into really high-tech, you know, stuff. And when I started working here, I worked at McLean McCann, so they had a lot of money, they had a lot of computers, all of this stuff. So I come into Cup of Coffee Animation, which was in this building right above us. And so I come in, and they had the lowest technology you could imagine. I was like, oh shit, I made a huge mistake here. And so, you know, I work in a bunch of projects, and I almost quit because, like, all their computers were beige. And this is when, like, Apple, Apple was coming out with the multicolor ones. And so I come in, and like, holy shit, like, where am I? And I thought, and this was a studio where I actually wanted to work, and it was sort of like a big shock that how are you making all this stuff with like beige computers? And then, so anyway, like I worked, and it kind of worked out, and I managed to be in charge of the broadcast design department, and I wasn't doing a lot of character animation. It was mostly typography and all this stuff. And so I'm on it, but I'm still like to do, I'm the one saying like, let's do this 3D, let's do this, you know, with a bunch of higher technology. Then Cup of Coffee moves up the street to 215 Spadina, and our department grows, and we're big. By the way, I'm also a huge music fan. And then finally, a gig comes in. And although I'm a big music fan, I'm not a big Rush fan, but the gig is with Rush. Right, they're doing a tour, and what they wanted to do was do a small interstitial film with them. And at that point, they had promotional bobbleheads of all three of the members, and they come in. I'm like, I want to do something with this, and we're like, okay, well, how are we gonna do this? I don't know. You guys figure it out. Do it. So we figure a way to do it. We don't do that much animation because we're actually shooting live. And what they were saying is like, well, the whole point of this is that we have this, the band's gonna play a part of their concert, and then we're gonna go into like one of the intermissions, and then this is gonna play, and then we're gonna come back, and it's gonna be Tom Sawyer, and it's gonna be amazing, right? Tom Sawyer's gonna play after that. And so we're actually excited because it's a nice project they gave us. They said, just do anything you want with this. And we built marionettes. It was amazing. It was one of the best projects we had. It was at the height of my tenure at Cup of Coffee. And so we're almost done, and we're all happy with this. And by the way, just to step back, immediately when I came to Toronto, I started making friends with musicians, right? My best friend and one of our partners is, has been in the Toronto music scene for a while, and a lot of people at Cup of Coffee were musicians. And so we'll keep that aside. I'm just gonna come back. So we're at this point. We're working. We're building sets. We have everything ready, and we're setting up for the last scene. And it's the band playing, and we go like, okay, well, after this, the bobbleheads are gonna be doing this and fade into like whatever other thing Rush has, and Tom Sawyer comes in. And then their producer comes in, and I'm like, how's it going? Great. And then he goes to Warren Brown, which is, he was co-directing with me, and he goes, well, but as we spoke, the bobbleheads have to bob to the drum beat of Tom Sawyer when it starts, because then we're gonna shoot that, and then the lights are, the screen's gonna go on, and the band's gonna start playing Tom Sawyer. But the first bits of this have to happen with the bobbleheads. And at this point, we can't control the bobbleheads. Like, you know, they're doing this, and we're like, and Warren and I were like, shit, this is the last day of shooting. What the hell are we gonna do? So immediately, my high tech, brain comes in. All right, we shoot this. We take the heads off the bobbleheads. We shoot this, we shoot the heads separately, and we just do it in post and shoot a clean plate, everything. We're like, and obviously, like, is this gonna work? How are we gonna do this? The cameras are not that good. Can we guarantee this? It's gonna look like shit because we already have a camera move. How are we gonna track all of this? So we're there for like a few hours, and we don't know how to fix this. And at some point I remember then Henry, our DOP, who's worked on other stop-motion series for A Cup of Coffee, the week before, there was a review in Now magazine of their show. And Henry's band was a sort of like a math rock instrumental, like a band, and he was a drummer. And his drumming was described as precise as a robot. So I'm thinking of this, and like, I go, Henry, would you be able to match the drum beat of in Tom Sawyer? I goes, yeah, like I just, I have to do this. And it just dawned on me, why am I thinking about all this high-tech stuff right now? So we got the props department. Literally what we ended up doing is tying a fish line in the back of all three members of Rush. Put it down through the stage. Henry said, just press this button on the camera to go. And Henry went down into the floor, grabbed the fish line. We play Tom Sawyer. We had a monitor there. And as the drums come in, actually it was as the guitars come in, he just went and matched that dun-dun, dun-dun. perfectly. So we have this, it's great, everything goes perfectly, and for me the lesson was, and this is a general lesson that I had at Cup of Coffee, it always brought me back to those beige computers, and I said, you do not need the latest thing to do good work and to solve problems. Sometimes masking tape and a fish line would do the job. And a friend who's a drummer.